guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Monique. If you're not new here, thank you so much for coming back. I know it's been a long time, but I am back with another Pupdate Thursday. Yes, I know it's been a long time, and I have my two Santa's little elves, Oreo and Brownie. Hopefully they'll be in the whole video. Brownie will probably leave. It's early and she's still tired. But anyways, really quickly, let me give you a little pup date on Oreo. He is now 6 months old. He's becoming into his own. He's very playful. He loves to play fetch. He's very affectionate. He likes to cuddle, and he gets on everybody's nerves because he's always into something. He's really a puppy, and he's becoming a really big boy. Okay, and I got these little cute little sweaters. I figured I'll get some wear out of them. It hasn't really been that cold yet in St. Louis. But yeah, I figured I'll get some wear out of them in the video. I did get these from Five Below. So Five Below is a really good place to get like your little dog clothes and stuff, because they're usually $5. Okay, so anyways, in today's video, I figured a lot of people are probably getting new pets for Christmas. So this video is probably late. You probably already have the pet, but if you don't, I did want to make a comparison video between getting adopting an adult dog versus getting a puppy. So I'm gonna go over some pros and cons of getting a puppy versus an adult dog, since I have experience with both. So these are my experiences. Your experience may be different, but this is what I experienced. Okay, I did write down a few notes just so I can remember. So I may be looking back here. That's just to read off my paper. As far as searching for an adult dog versus a puppy, when I searched for Brownie, I really was looking at any type of shelter, pet rescue. You can even try the Humane Society or anything like that. If you're looking for a particular breed, that can be a little difficult depending on what breed it is. I know a lot of times they have like pit bulls for in rescues and, or you know, shelters and stuff like that. But if you're looking for something more specific, like a Boston Terrier or I know French Bulldogs are very popular, it could be harder if you're looking for an adult dog and you're going through like a shelter or something like that. What I would suggest you do is, one, either look for a specific rescue for that breed of dog. So I know for Boston Terriers, they have like the American, the American Boston Terrier Rescue Group, or they have a Midwest American Boston Terrier Rescue Group, something like that. So you can look, try to check out a rescue group, or you can do what I did with Brownie. A lot of times, unfortunately, when these dogs, if they're in some type of puppy mill, or you know, they're breeding them or something like that, and they're just using these dogs to breed, a lot of times they will retire the female dog when she gets about 4, 5, 6. And that's kind of how I got Brownie, because she basically was a retired breeding dog, and I got her from a rescue. I basically searched Boston Terrier. I think I found her on Pet Finders, and she was with a rescue group that had an event at a PetSmart, and that's where I went to go actually see Brownie in person, and where I determined that I wanted her. So yeah, those are some ways that you can get an adult dog, and they also have puppies as well. As far as getting like a puppy, especially if it's a full bred dog, it's a little bit harder, because now you have to find a decent breeder, which can be hard. Even if you're going through a shelter, you want to make sure that they're taking care of their puppies properly, because I've seen a lot of cases, whether you get the dog from a breeder that's kind of shady or some type of shelter where they're not taking care of the puppies and the puppies don't have their necessary shots, the puppies can get very sick and sometimes they can die. So that's something that you want to make sure of. So you want to make sure the, you know, it's a good breeder, or even if it's a shelter, it's kind of hard to know if they're doing their what they're supposed to do, but you have to check for those type of things. Something else to be aware of, if you're getting a like full bred puppy like Oreo or Scams, I'm sure you've heard of them. What I would suggest doing and what I did was I found a local breeder. I actually went through a Boston Terrier Facebook group and I found a local breeder here in St. Louis that I was able to drive to actually see what the dog's parents look, what Oreo's parents look like, and you know, see the conditions, see the conditions and you know, how they're bred, and then determine from there. And I also was able to see my puppy so that I know, you know, when we're exchanging, I'm actually getting a dog. So I would say that I would definitely say do not have the dog shipped to you. I wouldn't do it, me personally, or pay any type of deposits or anything like that. Like, that's kind of, I wouldn't do that. So those are kind of like some comparisons between getting a, and Brownie's out of here, an adult dog versus a puppy. Something else, as far as comparing the two, would be cost. So as you can imagine, getting an adult dog is much cheaper than getting a puppy, and it's going to be whether the dogs are full bred or not. So I think just because the dogs are older, so since Brownie is older, since Brownie was older when we got her, of course she's going to be cheaper than getting a puppy. And Brownie, I believe she was like $200 or something like that. Oreo, I paid $700 for, and that was just the upfront cost. Puppies also cost a lot more when you think about aftercare. With Brownie, she was already spayed. She already had all her shots. All I had to do was get her a rabies shot and, you know, give her a little checkup to make sure she was healthy. With Oreo, yeah, it was months of me going back to the doctor so that he can get his full round of shots. He still has not been fixed, but I also would have to pay for that. So yeah, they have to be dewormed. So yeah, getting a puppy is much more expensive all the way around than getting an adult dog. So that's definitely something to think about. Okay, and then you want to think about temperament and behavior. So this is going to be preference based. I know initially when I got Brownie, the kids were like, she's boring, because she was an older dog, so she wasn't hyper. She did not want to play fetch. She played a little bit more when we first got her. She was like 4 or 5, so she did, you know, play a little bit more. But there was a lot of things that she just didn't do, I think, because like she was really used for breeding and she wasn't like a pet. So it was a lot of things that she just didn't do. So they kind of thought she was boring at first because she likes to sleep and lay around. As far as Oreo, as you can tell, hopefully you can see this going down, him acting crazy. Oreo has a lot of energy, and he's very playful to the point now where they're like, why won't he just sit down somewhere like Brownie, you know? So they're never going to be happy. But I would say if you have children or something like that, you may want to get a puppy, or if you're very active, a puppy, or you have a lot of time to dedicate towards a puppy, then that a puppy would be good for you. But if you're someone who's probably don't spend a lot of time at home and you're not that active, then you would be just fine with a, you know, an adult dog, because they're calm, they're laid back, it's not a lot of fuss. So that's a good thing. Another thing to think about is potty training. Now, this could or couldn't be the case, but sometimes when you get an adult dog, they already have some type of potty training. Now, I will say this. It doesn't matter what you do. Whenever you bring a new dog into your house, it's going to be some type of adjustment. They're going to make some type of accidents, even if they, you know, they do say that the dog is potty trained. They still have to adjust to your home, but it will be much easier than trying to potty train a puppy for two reasons. One, because they have some experience being potty trained, and two, because they're an adult dog and their bladders are larger, especially if they're a larger dog. With puppies, not only do they have to learn to go use the bathroom outside, but their bladders are just small because they're puppies. So they usually say, I know like for Oreo, they said he needed to go out about an hour for each month he was. So he's 6 months now, so that means that he probably can hold it for about 6 hours now. So that's kind of like a little rule of thumb. With adult dogs, I think Brownie, because she had to get used to the household, she held it for a couple days. Like, she didn't pee or do anything, which was odd. And that's another thing when it comes to temperament, another thing to consider when you're getting a puppy versus an adult dog is how they will adjust to a home. An adult dog, of course, is coming from some other home that they're used to, and some of those dogs will have a hard time adjusting. Brownie was one of those dogs. She suffered from depression. She tried to run away a lot of different times. So even still, she's the way Oreo is, the way he's very cuddly and he'll come up on me and get up underneath my arm and just lay down. Brownie won't do, now she will do that now because I think she's jealous of Oreo. So she's like, I wanna lay on your lap too, but she's never done stuff like that. So I feel like if you get a puppy and he grows with your family, or she grows with your family, they're going to be a little bit more attached to you than an adult dog. So that just kind of, again, depends on preference, if that matters to you. If you want your dog to be just so in love with you, then probably get a puppy. If you just, you know, companionship, you just want the dog to chill out with you, an adult dog would do fine. But as I stated, because they've had a different home, sometimes their adjustment can, you know, it can be a little bit difficult. They can suffer from depression and stuff like that. Brownie definitely suffer from stuff like that. So that's something to take in consideration. Okay, and I knew I was going to forget something. Something else I forgot to mention, especially when we're talking about training the dogs and, you know, potty behaviors. So a puppy is much easier to train than an adult dog. You've heard the saying, you can't teach an old dog new tricks. Like Oreo, we were able to teach Oreo how to sit really easily. Brownie, I really believe she probably does know those commands, but she's just like, look, I'm not about to do it. So yeah, it's kind of hard to older dogs can be stuck in their ways, whereas puppies, they're really easy to train. And because you're getting the dog so young, you can kind of make that dog how you want it to be, train it how you want it to be, and kind of break some of the before the behaviors even start, kind of stop some of those behaviors, bad behaviors before they start. But if you get an adult dog, you may get a dog that already has some inherited bad behaviors. So that's something else to consider. So how much time do you have to dedicate towards spending with these different dogs? Like I said, an adult dog, they're not going to require as much time as a puppy. They're kind of chill, they're laid back. Puppies, they're going to want a lot of attention. They're going to be into a lot of things, so you're going to have to watch them more than what you would have to do with an adult dog. Like, if we don't watch Oreo, he's going to be biting on furniture. He's going to, you know, he's going to be going going crazy. He needs attention. He wants to play. Brownie, she's very laid back. She can lay down. She kind of wants you to leave her alone anyway. So it's just, you know, so it's just different though. I love both of my dogs for different reasons. It's kind of like my kids. You know, they always ask me, which one do you love the most? And I always tell them I dislike you both equally. But I really I love them both for different reasons. So that's the big one. But that's so that was just a few pros and cons and differences between getting a puppy or an adult dog. Another thing to think about. I know puppies are absolutely cute. So when you see them, you're going to be like, oh my God, I want the puppy. He's so cute. Or she's so cute, so adorable. Everybody loves puppies. It's like babies, or human babies, I should say, because they are babies. But when you adopt an adult dog, you know that you're rescuing that dog and getting a dog, you know, off the street and giving it a home. So, or you're rehoming it, giving it a forever home. So that's something else to think about. So those were just a few things to think about if you are trying to figure out if you should get an adult dog or a puppy. So that's today's Pupdate Thursday. I hope you found this information somewhat informative. I probably forgot to say some things. I'm sorry if I did. If I did, I'll do like a part two to this video. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. Please subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. I'm going to try to get back into being more consistent. Anyways, until next time, peace out.